the Chef's Kitchen. I'm your host, Hope Cohen. Today I'm with James Barrett, co-owner of Metropolitan Bakery in Philadelphia. Great to see you and have you back in the Chef's Kitchen.
Thank you. It's nice to be here.
It's always a pleasure to bake with you, James. Your products are amazing. I can't wait to see what you're making today. I see lots of chocolate, which makes me happy.
So who doesn't like chocolate?
I don't know.
In addition to the great breads that we're known for, we also make some wonderful desserts. And I'll tell you, we're 15 years old this year.
Yay!
And
Happy birthday to you. Thank you so much.
But in one of the, just as long as 15 years, we've been making this flourless chocolate cake, and it's probably our most popular, next to our layer cake, and it is absolutely delicious.
There happens to be one over here. I just have to give a little reveal. It looks fab.
That is it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start by melting some bittersweet chocolate, and it's about 72% cocoa.
I wish people at home could smell the kitchen because it reeks of chocolate.
So this is my little trick here.
Okay.
I want to make a parchment circle so that I can line the bottom of our cake, and that will facilitate an easy unmolding of our cake. So I just do some folds. I take my cake pan, and I'll turn it upside down, and then I'll mark the center. And then I just make a cut.
It's a great trick.
Thank you.
And parchment paper is simply unwaxed wax paper.
Exactly. And then there, you have a wonderful circle that will fit the diameter of the pan.
Beautiful.
I'm just gonna take some softened butter. If you'd like to melt it, you can melt it. Or you can just simply use one of those non-stick sprays that make everything easy. And I'm going to line.
That's a great tip for people at home because, you know, I myself have, you know, I put the pan on the piece of paper, I cut around it, but it's never the right size, so that's great.
So, well, this really helps. So our chocolate is melting nicely and just over a pan of lightly simmering water. Careful, it's very hot.
That's your double boiler.
That's our double boiler, exactly. Perfect. So the chocolate that I'm using today is about 72% cocoa. And that just refers to the amount of cocoa and the amount of sugar. And so it's fairly bitter, but I like that.
I like that too. What type of chocolate do you recommend for people baking at home?
I really like Calibo chocolate. I think it's great.
It's good.
It's really good chocolate. And there's a great source of chocolate on the internet if you just, you know, go and type in chocolate. There's a very specific site which will come up. And any chocolate that is available to me will be available to you as a home baker. It's really great.
Chocolate.com or something?
It's a Chocosphere.
Okay.
And so any chocolate that I, as a professional baker, can get, you can mail order.
That's good news.
I start mine by creaming butter with the sugar. A lot of recipes that do flourless chocolate cake will call for melting the butter with the chocolate. And I find that I get a different texture that is more moist. It's a cross between a cake and a brownie.
I love that.
It's really, really wonderful. And you know, you keep all this beautiful butter kind of in a solid mass, as opposed to melting it, where the butter will separate and the milk fat separate from the fat.
It's more cake-like, right?
It's it is a cross between a cake and brownie.
I love that texture.
It's a hard description. It's really moist, but it's light at the same time. So I'm going to add some sugar. Just drizzle it in.
Granulated white sugar.
Granulated white sugar. And now I want this to become nice and light and creamy, and it'll take several minutes while that is happening. So while that is creaming, why don't we separate our eggs? So in here I have 4 eggs. I'm going to clean hands. You must have impeccably clean hands to do this. It's much easier.
Yeah. Well, your hands are a great tool.
Yes. Impeccably clean hands. And I very gently let the egg whites fall through my fingers. So our butter and sugar is creaming nicely.
And that's a really important step for the lightness.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Okay. Yeah. I want to facilitate an even mixing, so I'm just going to scrape the bowl. Bring all that sugar and butter down the sides. And if it's wrapped around the paddle, just scrape it down.
Have you seen this new attachment that they've made for the paddles that actually scrapes the side of the bowl while it's working?
I'm in the Stone Age, I haven't.
I just, it's something
that sounds amazing.
Curious. Yeah.
It makes life a lot easier, right?
Yeah.
So what I'm looking for, I'm listening because I want to hear that the sugar has been melted. I know it sounds weird, but you can actually hear the crystals rubbing against the side of the bowl. And when you don't hear that anymore, that means the sugar has been melted. Look for the coloring of the butter and the sugar.
It's a lot lighter.
It's a lot lighter. It's starting to look very creamy. And we're just about there.
You're not the first chef who's told me that they use their sense of hearing in cooking. I mean, often with chefs cooking in the kitchen, they listen for sounds when things are cooking in the pan. So it's an important sense to use.
Absolutely. Cooking involves all the senses. They're all involved. Okay, so there we go. Now, we want to, very carefully, because you don't want to make a cocoa mess. So, I'm...
No cocoa in the face?
No. The messes I have created by making chocolate pound cakes and flourless chocolate cakes,
cocoa
adding the
facial.
Cocoa. See, so always kind of pulse it on, off.
Just until the powder gets incorporated?
Just until it's incorporated. So now we're safe, okay? So now we'll just let that incorporate.
Slow.
And then we're gonna take the egg yolks and we're gonna start to mix those in.
One at a time,
allowing it to blend. There we go. So you can see all the cocoa is beginning to moisten. I'm actually gonna turn it up a little faster. Add another egg yolk.
You're making sure that each one is incorporated before you add the next.
So if you think about what we're doing here in this step of the formula is we're making chocolate butter.
Yum.
Right? We have cocoa, we have sugar, butter, and eggs.
Yeah.
Doesn't that sound delicious already?
Yeah.
And so you can just imagine what the texture would be like, you know, once it's baked. And we're going to bake it in a special way that will then also enhance that creamy, rich texture. There, so that looks gorgeous.
It looks beautiful, great
texture.
Now
we just have
shiny and
dark. One more egg yolk. So I hope I'm going to do one more scrape down.
It smells
great.
Okay,
and so you can see, so look how beautiful that is.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. Right? I wanna just like.
Not yet.
I know.
And it has raw egg yolks in it.
I'll control myself.
Okay.
Somehow. My daughter has a t-shirt. It says, drop the chocolate and no one gets hurt.
That's a great t-shirt. That's a great saying. I'm adding some vanilla. And then with all my baking, I like just a little bit of salt. And for my baking, I use kosher salt because it's larger granule. It will dissolve nicely, but it's not iodized.
It doesn't have any off flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And it brings out the flavor.
Exactly. I add salt to all my baking. Of late, it's become kind of trendy to put salt and finished salt on cookies and various sweets. But as most professional bakers, we've always known that trick. And so in anything that we're baking, we've always added a pinch of salt, whether it be an ice cream custard, a sorbet. It just enhances the flavor. So this is ready and this is beautiful. Now we need our chocolate very carefully because that bowl is really hot.
We have 15 minutes, James. And I wanted to point out our flowers on the set today are from Eventine Florists in Philadelphia. They do a beautiful job.
They're amazing.
Yeah.
They're so amazing.
Great flowers and arrangements. You may.
When you take the chocolate off of a double boiler, there may be some water condensation on the bottom. And so always just wipe it off before you pour it into your mixer so that the water condensation doesn't fall in.
Good tip. Because you don't want to water down this delicious cake-like brownie thing that
exactly.
we're eating.
All right.
Are you finished with the water now?
I am, thank you. So now on low speed, I'm going to add the chocolate down the sides of the bowl. Can you see that?
I can see, and it's shiny and delicious
mm-hmm.
looking.
Oh, look at that. Look how beautiful the chocolate is. Shiny, it's nice and viscous. You want the chocolate to cool a little bit before you add it to your butter mixture because you don't want that hot chocolate, if it's too warm, to melt the butter. I'm just going to whip it for, you know, maybe a minute, make sure that everything is blended. And then we're gonna take that
off.
Are you finished
with this?
I am. Ah, see, there you go. Very
wow.
good.
That's chocolate.
Okay, so now the warm chocolate has cooked the egg yolks enough.
Beautiful.
So that now it is safe if you would like to have another taste.
Just to make sure everything's okay.
You're free to go ahead and do that. I have some egg whites. And this is the key to this flourless cake. Now, here's a trick. If you don't have two bowls to your mixer.
Immersion blender.
You can use an immersion blender.
Great.
And
that's a great way to beat
fine.
Egg whites.
Right?
Like that. That's great. You can just see how they whip up.
Mm-hmm. So we're just gonna whip them. Had I had a second bowl, I would remove that and then put these into my stand mixer.
With a whisk.
And with the whip attachment, and just whip them until I got soft peaks.
But now you do it right in the bowl.
But I'm just doing this with the emulsion blender, and I'm bringing air in.
And you're looking for soft peaks.
I'm looking for soft peaks.
And this is gonna really add a lot of lightness and air.
Exactly, this will add the volume that we're looking for and the lightness. Okay.
It's just starting to get soft peaks. You can see when you pull up the,
exactly.
the blender that it holds a little bit.
Right.
It's a great tool.
It is. The emulsion blenders are really, really great. Okay. So may I give you this?
You may.
Thank you. So now I'm going to pour the egg whites in. And I'm going to fold gently.
So you don't want to deflate the eggs.
Exactly.
Because you've built up all of that air into
exactly.
them.
Exactly, yes.
That's why when you first start to fold, it's such an important step.
Exactly.
To be gentle.
Exactly. A little bit, stir it, fold, and then just a little stirring and then folding. I'm making sure that I scrape everything down from the sides of the bowl to make sure that it's incorporated.
So good.
There it is, okay. If there's a little lumps of egg whites, don't worry about it. A little streakiness, that's quite all right. I just pour it into our prepared pan.
Great.
Thank you.
The aroma of chocolate is overpowering and overwhelmingly yummy.
Yes.
I love it.
Now we're going to bring it to our oven. And we have the oven preset to 325 degrees.
Great.
And I'm very carefully, I'm going to leave it hanging off the ledge just a little bit, and I'm going to pour some water in.
So it's a water bath.
It's a water bath. And what this will do is it will allow the cake to cook, but very slowly and very gently. A lot of times what will happen when you're doing flourless chocolate cakes, if the temperature is too high, and it will souffle, and then it will drop. And so you'll get this kind of, concave cake, or sometimes it's sunken on the sides
so
because
you
the temperature
even.
Was too hot. And so okay. you want it slow.
Actually, this
and
oven
even.
Is set a little bit high. Can I turn it down for
yes.
you?
Yes.
There you go.
Okay. 325. Thank you.
You're welcome.
We're going to close the door, and we're going to let that slowly bake for approximately 45 minutes to 55 minutes.
Okay.
And you're going to test it, and the skewer should just come out clean. A little clingy of the chocolate is fine. So what we do, after it chills, we're going to allow it to chill overnight, and then we are going to take our cake.
So this is something you want to make the day before.
Exactly.
Great. We have 10 minutes, please.
Great. We're going to mold our cake. May I hand that to you?
Yes.
So what I did was, there are several ways to finish your cake. And so we let it chill overnight, and then we very gently run a knife around the sides to release it.
It's an important step.
This is the scary part, okay? I use a cardboard circles, but you can use a plate, that's fine. And very carefully, okay?
Flip.
You turn it over. Hopefully it will have fallen out.
Cross your fingers.
Which it has.
Very
okay.
nice.
Beautiful. Now,
and the paper stays in the bottom of the pan and releases it and nothing's stuck.
Exactly. Sometimes the paper will come out of the pan,
mm-hmm.
which is no problem.
You just peel it.
You just peel it off gently. All right.
Look how pretty.
So look how perfect that is, right?
Yeah.
So you can see how nice and even it is.
Are you a professional or something?
You could do this at home. This is, let me tell you, this is one of the most simple recipes that you can prepare.
Well, and you've illustrated that
Thank you. Really well. I have another glaze. Several options for finishing your cake. You can simply dust it with cocoa powder or powdered sugar and serve it with whipped cream or ice cream, or you can prepare a chocolate glaze, in which case I would just take...
Why not? That's right? What I say.
Right? I would take chocolate and I would melt that in another double boiler.
What you have going here.
Right. That is the final glaze.
Okay.
So we're going to turn that off.
Does that need to be whisked or stirred or anything?
Yes, please.
May
Go
I?
Ahead and whisk that. And if you would excuse me for a second.
So what kind of glaze is this?
This is the chocolate, which I've melted, and then I simply take heavy cream, some cognac.
Yum.
You can use the alcohol of your choice, Grand Marnier.
Whatever you like the flavor.
Whatever you like.
Bourbon.
If you don't like any alcohol, then just leave it out.
Okay. You could use Chambord if you want raspberry.
Chambord. I take a little bit of butter and corn syrup.
Okay.
And some cocoa powder.
Lovely.
And I turn that and I whisk that until that's smooth.
Turn it on.
Mm-hmm. And then we'll melt. The corn syrup allows the glaze, when it's set at a room temperature, to keep a shine on the cake, the final cake.
That's great. You're using our director's mother's saucepan, I want you to know.
Okay,
it's
I'm so touched. That's great. That means a lot of loving has gone into this pot.
That's true.
Right? Once that is boiled, just comes to a boil, the butter is melted, the corn syrup, the cocoa is smooth, I would then take my melted chocolate and I would just whisk it together.
I see.
Okay? Now, I hope I have already prepared some for you.
Okay, so this was to illustrate, and we
don't
need this right now.
So now here is our final chocolate glaze.
So that's that.
That is that. That is the heavy cream. Mm. The brandy,
yum,
mixed with the corn syrup, the
butter,
and
it's shiny and beautiful.
The chocolates. It is. Now, sometimes, depending upon how warm it has gotten, it may separate on you. Don't be alarmed. You can simply bring it back together by stirring in a little more heavy cream.
Good to know.
Okay. So now I'm going to take my cake, which I have put onto this cooling rack. It also doubles as a glazing rack. If I was doing chocolates and I was coating chocolates with tempered chocolate, or even we do these wonderful marshmallows that are piped out onto a homemade graham cookie,
mm-hmm.
And then we take tempered chocolate, we would use a rack.
That's great.
They are really great and they're all purpose.
S'mores.
Oh, yes. So we take the chocolate glaze, we pour it over the cake, be generous.
It's a beautiful thing.
And then we just help push it down the sides.
It's great.
If you feel you need more, then you just add more, okay? And then you would
Gorgeous.
Just lift that and let it set in the refrigerator overnight, or if you can wait that long to eat it. Most of us can't.
Is this recipe in your cookbook?
This is in the cookbook.
Because your cookbook is fantastic, and
Thank
I
you.
Love the recipes.
Thank you so much. So, Hope, here is a finished cake that I have for you, and we have some whipped cream, and here are the other options that I spoke
Voila.
Of, either powdered sugar or cocoa powder, but we decided to do the glaze instead. So I'm just going to take a knife, which I have in hot water, and very carefully slice through.
It's very dense.
It is dense. It's moist. It's rich.
How did you get the sort of striated line in the glaze?
After I glazed the cake, you have good eyes. That's very perceptive of you.
Thank you.
I let the first glaze set for just about 5 minutes, and then I took a spoon with the remaining glaze and held it up over, and I just drizzled back and forth.
Over the
over
initial
the
glaze.
Cake. But you just want to wait about 5 minutes. You don't want to let
it
completely set.
It makes
set.
A nice design.
For such a simple cake,
yeah.
You don't want anything fancy.
We
you can
a,
do chocolate curls.
We need
curls.
A plate.
Need
Let
a
me
plate.
Bring this.
You can do chocolate
That's
curls or chocolate
beautiful.
Shavings if you like, or you know.
Anything, right?
Anything you like. Mm.
Wow.
So we'll see.
It's gorgeous.
Thank you. There you go.
Look at that. The texture, I mean, I can already see, like you said, very, very dense, moist.
Would you like some whipped cream?
Yes. I would never say no to whipped cream.
Should we eat over there?
Yeah. Great. I would never say no to whipped cream.
I love whipped cream. And you can serve this with chocolate sorbet, raspberry sorbet.
How about the chocolate shavings over the whipped cream?
Some chocolate shavings.
Or fruit. I mean, you could do whatever you want,
sure.
Right?
Sure. Whatever you want.
There is no no.
When it comes to chocolate, there's a no no.
I like that.
The other thing, speaking of that, is it's also fun if you are interested to flavor the chocolate cake further. You can use some cinnamon, you can use citrus zest, cardamom, green tea.
The options are endless.
Options are endless. Would you like to taste?
I would.
You go first.
Let's do it together.
Okay.
It looks great, and I was really craving something sweet and chocolatey, so you came at the perfect time of the day. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mmm. Wow.
Good, right?
So good. Wait, I need one more bite just to make sure. That's so good because it's not too sweet.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right, it's cakey, but yum.
But James. It's very moist. It's luscious.
Mmm. Mm.
And the wonderful thing about the Flourless chocolate cake is it can be elegant or as sophisticated as you like for any party. Or it can be as simple as rustic as you like.
It's delicious and I love it. I can't wait to make a reservation at the restaurant or come to the bakery and pick up some great pastries.
Mm-hmm.
You do a great job. Thank you. It's great to have you back in the chef's kitchen.
It's so wonderful to be here. Thank you.
Thanks.
Flowers for the Chef's Kitchen provided by Eventine Design, Philadelphia's premier florist located at the Rittenhouse Hotel and Condominiums.